Hi guys, welcome back to Things Tina Does, and today I have another copycat recipe for you, Little Debbie's Oatmeal Cream Pies. I know they're a staple in my house, everybody loves them, and I'm going to show you how to make them at home from scratch, and they're better than Little Debbie's, so let's get into it. All right guys, step one, you have 2 sticks or 1 cup of softened unsalted butter. So that goes into our mixing bowl. Guys, we're gonna cream the butter till it's just a little bit fluffy. Then I'm gonna add my 1½ cups of coconut sugar. Now, if you want to do this with just regular sugar, no problem. Do this with 3/4 cup of white sugar and 3/4 cup of brown sugar. Now, when it's nice and creamy and fluffy, we're gonna add our egg. And this is a good opportunity to scrape down those sides. And guys, make sure your oven is preheated 350 degrees. All right, that is nice and incorporated and fluffy. We're gonna add our vanilla. Hey guys, while we're mixing that up, make sure you're subscribed to the channel just in case you haven't already. All right, now that our creamed mixture is ready, we're gonna get our dry ingredients all incorporated. All right guys, while our creamed mixture is done, we're gonna get our dry ingredients incorporated very quickly and then add to the creamed mixture. So in goes our 1 cup of flaxseed, 3 cups of quick oats, not the regular large old fashioned. Then 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1½ teaspoons of baking soda. We're gonna whisk that all together just to combine it. Okay, so our dry ingredients are ready. We're gonna bring our cream mixture back over here and get that incorporated. All right, our cookie dough is mixed up and we're ready to put these out on our baking sheets. Okay guys, we've got our silk pads on our baking sheet. Like that. If you don't have silk pads or you don't want to use them, just put these out on a very, very lightly greased baking sheet, okay? And we're gonna, I love to use my little 1½-inch scooper for this. Put them out at about 2 inches apart on that baking sheet. We don't want them to run together, so we're giving them a little bit of room there. Okay, and look how fast that was. I've got 1 sheet done. I'm gonna fix the other sheet, guys, and then these are gonna go in the oven. Okay, into the oven they go. Okay, so these are in for 12 minutes. And okay, guys, now we're ready to make our very, very light cream cheese frosting. And the cream cheese is going in 8 ounces. So first of all, we're gonna get our cream cheese good and fluffy. Our cream cheese is fluffy. We're going to start adding our butter 1 tablespoon at a time, and this is unsalted and softened. Now we're going to scrape down our sides. That beautiful rye cookies are out at the 12 minute mark. We're going to put them on a cooling rack to cool absolutely completely before we ever start frosting them. All right guys, I'm using the powdered Swerve for this. The confectioner style powdered Swerve. If you want to just use powdered sugar, go ahead. But you guys know I'm sugar alternative, so we have found a way to do it. Okay, now we stopped right here because I wanted to explain to you guys what I'm doing. I'm adding the confectioner style Swerve and the 1½ alternately into the mixer in order to do 2 things. One, we want to remove all the lumps from the cream cheese, those little lumps that can stay in there if you don't get them beaten out good enough. And then the second thing is I want to develop this consistency of my frosting slowly so that I can monitor how that's going. We're also going to go ahead and add our vanilla. All right. Yes. Okay. Let me show you guys this. Now, you might think that this is a little bit loose, and if we were frosting something else, it might be a little bit loose, like for a cake, if you really wanted the frosting to hold up well. But remember, I was telling you that I don't want this frosting to be heavy and dense, right? So we're kind of going for about that. It's almost like a loose whipped cream, about that consistency. The thing about this that makes this work so well is that when you put that dollop, when we put that dollop in between the cookies and sandwich them down, it's enough to get them to stick together, but it doesn't just ooze all out the sides. It's also not so thick that when you bite into it, all you taste is frosting. Okay, guys, our cookies are completely cool, and they usually come off of the seal pat rather easily just by giving them a light little twist like that. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna start. You get about a good dollop on a teaspoon like that. Not too much more than that. And just kind of pat it around like that. And then top with another cookie. And then we're just gonna set that aside so that it can firm up. And we're gonna go on with the next one. And look at that, you guys. That's all there is to it. Mmm. Oh yeah. Mmm. Just the right amount of that cinnamon with the vanilla in those cookies. It's so good, you guys. And that frosting, it's light and it's sweet, but it's not overpowering. It's just the right medium in between those two oatmeal cookies. You guys gotta give this a try. And when you do, let me know how it works out for you. And make sure you're subscribed to the channel, guys. And we'll see you next time on Things Tina Does.